Hello students, we'll continue with chapter 5, the fundamental unit of life, and we'll be starting with new topic today, that is cytoplasm. What exactly cytoplasm is? In a cell, the ground material, the ground substance is called as the cytoplasm, in which all these cell organelles are present, whether it is the nucleus or the mitochondria or ribosomes. These all cell organelles are present in a ground substance that is called as the cytoplasm. So when we look at the temporary mound of onion peel as well as human cheek cell, we can see a large region of each cell enclosed by the cell membrane. This region takes up very little stain. It is called the cytoplasm. So once we make the slide of onion peel, or if we make a slide of human cheek cell, then we observe that the region which is very lightly stained is the cytoplasm. Okay, and it is the ground substance of the cell. The cytoplasm is the fluid content inside the plasma membrane. See, this is the plasma membrane. Okay, so inside the plasma membrane, inner to it, cytoplasm is present. It also contains many special cell organelles. Each of these organelles perform a specific function for the cell, and all the organelles, they are enclosed by the membranes. To clear this point, I've already discussed in the previous class that the cell, it has different cell organelles, for example, mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum. These all cell organelles are present in the cytoplasm, and they have different functions. So in prokaryotes, besides the absence of defined nuclear region, the membrane bound cell organelles are also absent. In case of eukaryotic cells, the cell organelles are present and they are membrane bound. That means a membrane is present around them. But in case of prokaryotic cells, they don't have these cell organelles, they don't have the membrane. And the eukaryotic cells, they have well-defined nucleus. The nucleus has the nuclear membrane around it. And the other cell organelles also, they also have the membrane around them. Now, viruses, they lack any membranes, and hence they do not show characteristics of life until they enter a living body and use cell machinery to multiply. Now, what is a virus? Virus is non-living. Okay, it is said to be the connecting link between the living and the non-living organism. It is basically made up of DNA or RNA and the protein code. Now, if it is present outside the body of the organism, then it remains non-living. But once it enters the body of its host, then it becomes living inside the body of the host. Now, it takes up the machinery of the host to multiply itself. Fine, so the viruses, they also lack any membrane and they remain non-living. And once they infect their host, then they become living. Now, we'll be dealing with the different types of cell organelles one by one. We'll be studying them. First, let's see the introductory part. Every cell has a membrane around it to keep its own content separate from the external environment. Large and complex cells, including cells from multicellular organisms. See, in a particular cell, different functions are to be performed. So inside a particular cell, some functions are to be performed, and for performing those functions, different cell organelles are there. For example, the nucleus, it controls all the activities of the cells. The mitochondria, it helps in the production of energy. So different cell organelles in a cell has different functions. So large and complex cells need a lot of chemical activities to support their complicated structure. To keep these activities separate from each other, the cells use membrane bound little structures. The little structure present inside the cell which are enclosed by the membrane, they are called as the cell organelles. And these cell organelles, they have different functions. Okay, so this particular feature, it is present in eukaryotic cells. But in case of prokaryotic cells, well-defined organelles are even not present. The membrane is not present around them, and even some of the cell organelles might be absent in case of prokaryotic organisms. And these cell organelles are visible only under the electron microscope. Okay, now can we call plasma membrane a cell organelle? Can we call plasma membrane a cell organelle? It's not an organelle, but it shelters all the other cell organelles within it. Now we'll continue with the next topic, that is the endoplasmic reticulum. So what exactly the endoplasmic reticulum is? It is the network of membrane bound tubes and sheets. I'll show you with the help of this diagram. See, this is the nucleus, okay? This is the nucleus, this part, and this, you can see, connected to it are the different structures, cistern-shaped structures. This is called as the endoplasmic reticulum. Here you can see the rough endoplasmic reticulum as well as the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now, what is the difference between the two? On the rough endoplasmic reticulum, some tiny structures which are called as ribosomes are present on the surface. But in case of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, this is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So, on the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, the ribosomes are not present. So, I'll repeat again. What exactly endoplasmic reticulum? It basically forms a network through which the transport of molecules takes place. For example, it is connecting the nucleus. This is the nucleus they have shown. So it is connecting the nucleus, connected to the nucleus, and the proteins and the substances that are formed inside the nucleus, they are transported through the endoplasmic reticulum. So there is a network of membrane bound tubes and sheets. So endoplasmic reticulum is a large network of membrane bound tubes and sheets, and it looks like long tubules, round or oblong bags. It can be in the shape of round tubes, like you can see here, endoplasmic reticulum is in the shape of round tubes, or they can be oblong or bag shaped in structure. So endoplasmic reticulum, it is similar in structure to the plasma membrane. You remember the structure of the plasma membrane? It is made up of two lipid membranes, that means lipid bilayer, and certain proteins were also present in it. So similarly, the endoplasmic reticulum membrane is also made up of the similar kind of substances like that of plasma membrane. Now, there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, the rough type and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, RER and SER. So, RER looks rough because it has ribosomes attached to its surface. Now, what basically ribosomes are? Ribosomes are the sites of protein manufacture. That means proteins, the formation of proteins, it takes place on the ribosomes. That is why they are also called as the protein factory of the cell. Okay, ribosomes are called as the protein factory because the manufacture of proteins takes place on the surface of ribosomes. The manufactured proteins are then sent to various places depending on the need using the SER. I told you it forms the framework, and the transport of materials, it takes place along this framework, along this network. The SER helps in the manufacture of fat molecules or lipids, which are important for cell function. Now, the function of SER is that it helps in manufacture of fat molecules and the lipid molecules, which are important for functions of the cells. some of the proteins or lipids help in building the membrane. These process is called as membrane biogenesis. Okay, some of the proteins that are produced here in the endoplasmic reticulum, they help in building the cell membrane. Okay, building the cell membrane or the plasma membrane, and this process of building up of the cell membrane or the plasma membrane is called as membrane biogenesis. These proteins, some of these proteins and lipids, they also function as enzymes and the hormones. Okay, enzymes, they are the catalyst which alter the rate of the chemical reaction, and hormones are again the chemicals which control the different activities in the body of organisms. So these proteins and lipids which are manufactured, they function as enzymes and hormones also. Now the endoplasmic reticulum, it forms the network system in a cell. Functions of endoplasmic reticulum are, it serves as channels for transport of material. See, these are the channels. For example, the protein is manufactured here, suppose some substance is manufactured, then it's going to, its transport is going to take place through this particular network system. Okay, so it forms the channels for the transport of materials between various regions of the cytoplasm or between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. That means the substances that are formed inside the nucleus, they can be transported to the cytoplasm through this channel, or the transport of materials could take place within the cytoplasm through the endoplasmic reticulum. Functions as cytoplasmic framework, providing a surface for some of the biochemical activities of the cell. That means some of the biochemical reactions, some of the chemical reactions inside the cell, it takes place on the surface of endoplasmic reticulum. So we can say it like this, that it provides the surface for the biochemical reactions to take place. In the liver cells of the group of animals called vertebrates, SER plays a crucial role in detoxifying many poisons and drugs. Very important point, in liver cells, SER has a very important role. It detoxifies poisons and drugs. Okay, it is present in case of liver cells of animals. SER has an important role because it detoxifies the poisons and the drugs. Here you can see, with the help of this particular diagram, you can see how the transportation of the proteins takes place. See, this is the nucleus they have shown, and this is the endoplasmic reticulum. For example, a protein is formed here. Now this protein is going to be transported along this channel, that is along this network, endoplasmic reticulum, and it is transported to the Golgi body, and further it is going to be packed in the Golgi body, and it is going to be transported outside the cell. Now let's talk about the Golgi apparatus. Again, a very important cell organelle. Let's study the structure of the Golgi first. This is the Golgi apparatus. You can see the different bag-like structure. These are called as cisterns, cisternae, and this is one face of the Golgi, and this is the other face. This face is called as a cis face, and this is the trans face. The protein molecules, they enter from this particular part and they come out from here, from the trans face, and the packaging of the proteins takes place inside the Golgi apparatus. That is why it is also called as the post office of the cell. What happens in the post office exactly? The different types of letters, they come in the post office, they are sorted out and they are packed, and then they are sent to their destination. Similarly, in the Golgi apparatus, the different proteins are sorted out and packed, and they are sent to their different destinations. So that is why the Golgi apparatus, it can be compared to the post office of the, it is called as the post office of the cell. The structure was first described by the scientist Camillo Golgi. It is a system of membrane bound vesicles. Vesicles are what? Vesicles are small bags, flat bags. Okay, and they lie parallel to each other, and they are present in packets or stacks called the cisterns. And they are connected, these membranes, they are connected with the membrane of ER, and therefore it forms a complex cellular cellular membrane system, or we can say endomembrane system. You see, with the help of this particular diagram, this is the cell membrane system of the cellular endomembrane system. You can see the nucleus here, this is the endoplasmic reticulum, and this is the Golgi apparatus. Okay, this is the Golgi apparatus, this is the endoplasmic reticulum, and this is the nucleus. So the molecules that are formed here, they'll be transported along the endoplasmic reticulum. They will reach the Golgi, where the packaging will take place, and finally the packaged proteins are sent to further destination. So this system, this entire system, is called as the endomembrane system or the cell membrane system. Now let's see the functions of the Golgi apparatus. The material synthesized near the ER is packaged and dispatched to various targets inside and outside the cell through the Golgi apparatus. That means what are the different materials that are synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum, they are going to be packed and they will be sent to the different targets. The function include, it has more functions like storage and modification and packaging of the products. And where does this packaging takes place? Inside the vesicles of Golgi. In some cases, complex sugar may be made from simple sugar in Golgi apparatus. Sometimes simple sugar are converted into the complex sugars. The Golgi apparatus is also involved in the formation of the lysosomes. We will be talking about the lysosomes in detail. So the Golgi apparatus, it also involves in the formation of lysosomes. Lysosomes are called as the suicidal bags because they are another cell organelle which has the digestive enzymes present in it. Fine, now let's talk about the brief introduction of Camillo Golgi. It is mentioned in NCERT book. We will not leave anything from NCERT. We'll cover this portion also. So Camillo Golgi, he was born in 1843 in Brescia, and he went to University of Pavia, and after the graduation he continued to work in Pavia at Hospital of Saint Matteo. And basically his work was based on the his work was concerned with the nervous system. Finally he discovered the Golgi apparatus, and he received the Nobel Prize for his discovery in 1906. And whenever a person is receiving the Nobel Prize, automatically his name becomes very important. You can be asked a question, name the scientist who received the Nobel Prize for discovery of Golgi. So you must know the answer. So now the next cell organelle is lysosome. What exactly lysosome is? It is a small cell organelle which has digestive enzymes present inside it. And what is the function of these enzymes? They help either in the digestion of certain food particles, or they help in breaking down of certain bacteria. And sometimes when the cell gets old, then these digestive enzymes, they help in the digestion of the cell itself. That is why it is referred to as the suicidal bags. So they are membrane bound. Again it is written membrane bound. It means that a membrane is present around them, and it contains the digestive enzymes. These enzymes are made by RER, rough endoplasmic produces these enzymes. Now it is referred to as the waste disposal system. Why? Because the waste is disposed of with the help of enzymes that are present inside the lysosomes. They help to keep the cell clean by digesting any foreign material, as well as the worn out cells. The worn out cells or the damaged cells, they are cleaned up. How they are cleaned up? The lysosomes have digestive enzymes. These enzymes helps in digestion or breaking down of the worn out cells. Foreign materials, whatever the foreign material that enters the cell, or if in case food particle is there that enters the cell, it helps in digestion of the cell. Okay, it helps in breaking down that complex substance into simple one, and it helps in breakdown of bacteria. It helps in digestion of that bacteria. Lysosomes are able to do this particular process of digestion because it has digestive enzymes present in it. Okay, in case of disturbance in the cellular metabolism, what is metabolism? The different chemical reactions that take place inside the cell, they're referred to as metabolic processes or the metabolism. So in case any disturbance is there in the cellular metabolism, then or the cell gets damaged, then the lysosomes, they burst. Okay, these lysosomes, they burst, and the enzymes, the digestive enzyme, they are released out, and they help in the digestion of the cell. They digest their own cell, therefore they are also known as the suicide bags of the cell. Okay, so that's all for today, and we'll continue with next topic, mitochondria, in the next lecture. Thank you.